Good morning, class 11. Well, in continuation with the topic economics and economy, where already you all have studied about microeconomics and macroeconomics. So children, today you will be studying about the two more classification of economics, that is positive economics and normative economics. So when I talk about positive economics, it is that economics which deals with the economic issues which have been related to past, present or future. Now here under positive economics, it deals with those economic situations which could be studied by using the facts and figures. For example, if I say that on the eve of independence, poverty in India affected a larger percentage of population, then children, this observation is related to the past because I am talking about the independence time. Then if I say 22% of population in India is below poverty line, then it is observation of present, as it is related to present. And if I say that if the population continues to grow at the same rate, then within the coming years, it will exceed 22%. Now, this is an observation which has been related to the future. So, children, positive economics is the economics of what was, that is past, what is, that is present, and what would be, that is future. Now, here under positive economics, it highlights the nature and extent of economic problems and analyze those economic behavior of past, present and future. And the best part is that these statements are verified on the basis of facts and figures which have been related to past, present and or future, you can say. Now, these statements, children, they do not reflect any value judgment or opinion. Means that here, these statements, they do not come up with any of the value judgment or any of the opinion. The reason? Because these judgments are merely depends on the facts and the figures. So, there is no debate on these statements. Whereas, if we talk about normative economics, the normative economics, according to the economist, is an economics of what ought to be. When I say what ought to be, means it deals with the opinions of the economist. You know, the opinion of economist on the different economic issues. Now, on a same economic issue, the economist, a number of the economists may have a different opinion. They may come up with a different solution, or the opinion may involve, of course, involve the value judgment, because here everybody is coming up with their own opinion. For example, let's say Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act will one day bring an end to the problem of unemployment in the country is an opinion on Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Act by one of the economists. Whereas, according to the other economist, this Employment Act is just a program of financial aid to the unemployed people, which will make these people, you know, parasites or unproductive for a long period of a time. Means some of them believe that if this act will continue, it will make the people unproductive. Whereas some of them believed that it should not be persuaded until unless it does not create any kind of an assets. Means some of the economists believed that this program of Mahatma Gandhi National Employment Guarantee Act should not be implemented until unless this program gives certain kind of an assets. So children, these statements are called normative statement because here merely an opinion is there. So these opinions cannot be verified because there is no facts and figures. Rather, normative economics involves the value judgment. Here it leads to number of controversies and debate. But these opinions, controversies, debates cannot be verified for the truth. And that is why we say normative economics reflects what ought to be as a solution for the economic problem. Now, if we have to differentiate between the positive economics and normative economics, so you can say positive economics deals with economic issues or economic behavior which has been related to past, present and future, whereas normative economics deals with the opinion of the economist which has been related to the economic issues. Then under positive economics, it relates to what was, what is, what would be, whereas normative statement comes with the normative economics which relate to what ought to be. Then the statement of positive economics, children, are not necessarily the statement for or statement of truth. It might be, it might not be. Whereas normative statements cannot be termed as true or false because they are mainly involve only the opinion. So they are not been verified for true or false. Then under positive economics, facts and figures are there to verify for truth. Whereas under normative economics, the statements are not verified. They are merely the opinions. So children, positive economics does not involve any value judgment. The reason? Because here there is no opinion. Whereas normative economics, it involves the value judgment. Because here the economists, they come up with their opinion, with their judgment differently on a single or not same economic issues. So children, that is the difference between the positive economics and normative economics.